Tuskegee University, home to your Golden Tigers. And
we are live on the campus of Tuskegee University, getting set for Tuskegee baseball. The Golden Tigers getting set to meet the Tigers of Benedict College in the rubber match between these teams. Glad you could join us for our coverage here on the Golden Tigers Sports Network. Charles Ward here with the play-by-play story as the Tigers of Tuskegee University get set to determine who will win this three-game set between them and the Tigers of Benedict College. Team split on yesterday in doubleheader action. So the winner takes it all today here. They can take the win, with looking for the Golden Tigers to do just that. They come in 6-31 overall and 5-20 in SIAC play. Tigers of Benedict 12-16 overall and 7-14 in SIAC play. Tigers of Tuskegee University coming into ball game this afternoon. They'll be led on the mound by Kyrie Broughton. Broughton, the senior, will be handling the pitching for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee, and the Tigers of Benedict College will counter with Fareed Mazzell, the grad student from Philadelphia, Pennsylvania. That's the pitching matchup. Broughton on the season, 7.14 ERA, 2-4 in terms of one-loss record. This will be his 12th appearance on the season. He started in 7 ball games and completed 1 for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. 46 innings of work for Broughton over the course of the season. During that time, he's had 21 strikeouts, and teams are batting .306 against Broughton, the right-hander for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. For the Tigers of Benedict, Mazzell, ERA of 9. He has a 2-0 record for the Tigers of Benedict College. This will be his 4th appearance on the season, and his batting average with opposition is 3.349 per ball game, so just under 350 for opponents hitting against Mazzell. That's the pitching matchup for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. They'll shape it up this way defensively behind the dish. Catching Broughton this afternoon, it'll be Mark Hatch. At third base, it'll be Ryan Hayes. At shortstop, Alex Glass. At second base, Nicholas Pratt. And at first, Evan Jones. In the outfield for Tuskegee, going left to right, it'll be Coley Willis, Mikhail Mason in center, and Harrison Barnes, that is, in right field for head coach Reginald Hollins and the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. So in the batting order, it'll be Broughton, Hatch, Glass, Barnes, Jones, Hayes, Willis, Pratt, and Mason. That'll be the batting lineup for Tuskegee. For the Tigers of Benedict College, it'll be Jamel Mitchell leading off for them. Mitchell plays center field for Benedict. He will lead off. Jalen McDuffie, right fielder, will bat second for Benedict. And playing third base and batting third is Justin Murray. Todd Bates, the shortstop, will bat fifth for the Tigers of Benedict College, or fourth for the Tigers. It'll be Isaiah Canty batting in the number 5 spot. Canty is the left fielder for the Tigers of Benedict. Mizell, Hall, Jones, and Watson to follow. First pitch getting set. Broughton squares, and we're underway. First pitch thrown high as Mitchell takes that ball. Mitchell on the season batting .365. Curveball there by Broughton. That's over for his first strike of the ball game. One pitch on the way. Just off the plate. 2 balls, 1 strike. Just underway here at Tuskegee at Washington Field. Glad you could join us for the coverage. 2-1 pitch. That was swatted out to, going to get down for a base hit in left field. So Mitchell leads off with a knock to left field. Got it down for the base hit. Jalen McDuffie now on the bat for the Tigers of Benedict. Team split on yesterday. Golden Tigers winning the first ball game 15-2. And then in the nightcap, Benedict won that one 12-8. So a runner on. Pickoff move. They haven't picked off, but the pad, the throw to first base, got away from Evans Jones. And now rounding the third in with the slide is Mitchell. They had him picked off, but Jones could not handle the throw from Broughton. Like it could have been a catchable ball, likely going to be charged an error to the first baseman, Evans. And over the third goes Mitchell. pitch from Broughton, swung on and missed. Fastball by Broughton, giddy up on that one. Broughton with 21 strikeouts on the season, 38 base on balls coming into today's ball game. On the outside, this one's popped up. That one's going to go out of play, left side. So Broughton ahead in the count, 0-2. McDuffie, 349 batter for the Tigers of Benedict in the hole. Kyrie with the pitch. That one out of the zone high, trying to see if McDuffie wouldn't chase that. He did not, so the count to 1-2. Down at third base is Jamil Mitchell for the Tigers of Benedict. He singled and got to third on an error. This one popped up into center field. Mikhail Mason's got a bead on that one. Squares, and here comes the throw. And Mitchell was coasting for the first run of the ball game on the sacrifice fly by McDuffie. So Justin Murray coming up to the plate now for the Tigers of Benedict. Murray, the sophomore, leads the team in batting average at 448. 43 of 96 from the plate as he makes this appearance. Bases clean after the sacrifice fly. Pitch, that's on the zone. Broughton got it low at the knees for the strike. That one a bit inside, tried to locate to the same area, but missed that one on the inside. 1-1 count. And that one waved off as low as well. Two balls, one strike. And catching the corner with that one. Broughton evens it at 2-2. Murray with 36 RBI on the season takes a pitch on the inside. Kyrie Broughton, a senior from Stockbridge, Georgia. 3-2 pitch here. Foul tip at the plate. So Murray stays alive. Kyrie, an outfielder for the Tigers of Benedict as well. Overcast skies in Tuskegee, rain earlier this morning. Still some clouds now. Hoping the weather won't be a factor as this game is just underway. Benedict with a 1-0 lead after a single and an error and a sacrifice fly. 3-2 pitch here from Broughton. Missed that one on the inside, so Murray draws the pass. And he will be down at first base. Todd Bates now, the shortstop, coming into the box. Bates, a 413 hitter, 31 of 75 as he steps in. So Broughton now from the stretch and the pitch. Just off the plate. The 1-0 pitch, swing and a miss. Throw down to seconds, offline, and the base is going to be stolen there by Murray. Murray got a good jump there to steal second. So he is now in scoring position for Bates. Bates with 22 RBIs on the season for Benedict. Opening action in today's ball game. Good pitch on the inside there by Broughton, caught the corner. Ahead in the count, 1-2. Murray takes a lead at second. Broughton peers back that way. Now the pitch. Swung on, foul ball just in front of the Tuskegee dugout. Isaiah Canty, the left fielder on deck for Benedict. The The 1-2 pitch from Broughton. It's on its way. Foul tip as Bates stays alive. Kyrie ahead in the count for Tuskegee, trying to get this second out of the inning. The 1-2. That one bounces up there and it gets away from Hatch. And Murray will scoot over to third base for Benedict. Put that one down as a wild pitch there. Hatch did everything he could to try to block it and keep it in front of him. But the spinner kicked out. And the count goes now to 2-2. So Murray over the third. One down here in the top of the first. The pitch by Broughton. That one's low on the inside. Hatch did a good job of blocking that one.
All right, let's go. Come on, Doc.
Three-two pitch. Swung on. Hot shot to third base. Knocked down. Not enough time to get across the diamond. Yeah, did have enough time. Able to pick it up and recover was Ryan Hayes. Knocked it down to keep it in front of him and is able to get Bates running down the line and Murray holding at third base. So that second out, much needed second out, comes on the ground ball. Canty in the box now. That one. Popped up behind first base, circling inside, out of bounds, and the catch made there by Evans Jones. Good job of circling and keeping his eyes on the baseball. Wind not that heavy, but able to track it down and get out number three for Tuskegee. So the Tigers of Benedict come away with that one run in this first inning of play. So Tuskegee trailing at 1-0, and they get set to come to the plate. We'll do that after this timeout on the Golden Tigers Sports Network.
Are you looking for education that leads to career success and something more? We are Tuskegee University, one of the nation's top-ranked HBCUs. We believe in education to fulfill your purpose. Here, you work hard because you dream harder. By pursuing your purpose, you will make a difference. Are you ready for something big? Let's get started.
What does education mean? When you choose the top HBCU in Alabama.
So one of the things that's been most valuable for my experience at Tuskegee is being able to face challenges head on. I can definitely say here I've learned how to be an advocate for myself, how to speak up, and how to present myself in ways that can help me get opportunities, to help me fix things that may not be right. And I think that's really just the best skill that I've learned here that I can take with me for the rest of my life.
Look forward to your bright future. Apply to Tuskegee University today.
We're back live at Washington Field on the campus of Tuskegee University. Bottom half of the first inning, Tuskegee trailing 1-0 to the Tigers of Benedict College. And Tuskegee will be sending up the pitcher, Kyrie Broughton, to start things off offensively. Mark Hatch, the catcher, to follow. Alex Glass, the shortstop, set the bat third in the inning. And if they're able to keep it going, Harrison Barnes, Evans Jones, Ryan Hayes, Cody Willis, Nicholas Pratt, and Mikhail Mason. That's the batting order for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. Broughton, Hatch, Glass, Barnes, Jones, Hayes, Willis, Pratt, Mason. They will be going up against the left-hander, Fareed Mizell. Mizell on the season. Two wins, no losses. This is going to be his fourth appearance of the campaign. Mizell, eight strikeouts on the season, issued 12 base on balls. Batting average against him is .349. So Broughton stepping into the box. So let's see if Broughton can issue some offensive damage to the Tigers of Benedict. They hit him up for one in the top half of this inning. Rotten on the season. 9 of 56 from the plate. First pitch from Mizell. Middle of the plate on the fastball. So Mizell jumps ahead of his counterpart. Tried a curveball, but way out of the zone on that one. Count goes to 1-1. Jacob Hall doing the catching for the Tigers of Benedict. And set for the 1-1 pitch. That one low inside. Good look there by Broughton. Not to swing at that one. At the corners, Justin Murray at third and Jaden Jones at first for Benedict. And up the middle, Taj Bates at short and Amarian Watson at second. Good pitch there by Mizell. Splits the plate with a fastball down low. Count goes even to 2-2. Shot the gap. Nicely done there by Broughton. Just follow that pitch. Comes away with a single there to get on and get Tuskegee's offense started. Didn't try to do too much with that. Saw the gap to the right side. The pitch was up and out. He went after it and got it in right field for the base hit. So that'll bring up Mark Hatch, the catcher now. Hatch, the senior from Chicago. 18 of 65 batting. From the stretch, Mizell squaring the bunt. And he took a ball outside. Hatch, 385 slugging percentage, 10 base on balls. Again, showing bunt, but the pitch way out of the zone. Hatch with one home run on the season. Ahead in the count. Here's the pitch. Laid off of that one as well because it's out of the zone. So Mizell having some difficulty tracking the baseball in the strike zone. Hatch way ahead in the count now. 3-0. Squares again. This time he'll take a strike. Smart thing to do there. Gotta make him throw a strike to get that set going. Count to 3-1. This time he got it down. That's a good bunt there as well. Trying to slide past the first baseman, Jaden Jones. Not able to do that. Jones tags him out. But a good sacrifice there by Hatch. And a good deep count as well. Getting that pitch count up in the process. And doing its job of pushing Broughton down the second on the sacrifice. So Alex Glass, the shortstop now, he'll step in. A sophomore from Birmingham takes a curveball, which dips out of the zone. Looked good, but it dropped out of the zone just as it approached the plate. So Glass looking that one off. Another curveball, couldn't resist that one. Hits that one out of play just in front of the Tuskegee dugout. Glass leading Tuskegee in terms of the number of hits at 38 out of 109 opportunities. Also leads the team in RBIs with 22. In total bases of 49, he leads that category as well. 1-1 pitch here from Mizell. Glass swings and rips it out the center field, but right into the tracks of Jamil Mitchell, the junior, the outfielder for the Tigers of Benedict. Ball hit hard by Glass, but Mitchell barely had to move, may have taken one or two steps forward to catch it. So two down here now for Tuskegee in the bottom half of the first. Down at second base is Kyrie Broughton. They're trying to see if they can't bring him in.
Need one. Come on, get out of it.
Harrison Barnes takes a look at a pitch off the plate. Lefty-lefty matchup. Mizell on the mound. Barnes in the box. Barnes, 19 RBI on the season. Chance to pick up one here. 1-0 pitch on the way. Out of the zone with the curveball. Barnes with five doubles on the season, one triple, and one home run for the Golden Tigers. Good pitch there from Mizell. Finds the corner. Takes the count to 2-1. See the first baseman there. Jaden Jones playing back with the left-hander in the box, and Barnes. That one bounced up there by Mizell. Good stop by Jacob Hall behind the plate. Tuskegee trailing 1-0. They've got Kyrie Broughton down at second base trying to bring him in. Two down, bottom of the first. Fastball thrown there by Mizell with some pep on it. Got it past Barnes. Take the count to 2-2. Two-two pitch. There we go. I had it at 3-2. That's the fourth pitch for the walk there. So that was a 3-2 set with Barnes standing in, and he took the walk. So Barnes is aboard. Broughton's down at second base. And first baseman Evans Jones stepping into the box now, the sophomore from Tuscaloosa. Big knock here would really help. Swings at the first pitch and fouls it off. Jones tied for first on the team in home runs. But a base hit would do just nicely here. 0-1 pitch from Mizell. That one's off the plate. Take the count to 1-1. Ryan Hayes on deck for the Golden Tigers. Runners at first and second for Tuskegee. That one off the plate as well. Jones back in the box. Ahead in the count 2-1 now. Mizell delivers. Swung on, tapped at the plate, stays in fair play. Unfortunate for the Golden Tigers there. Just creased that baseball in terms of swinging at it. Thought it may have rolled foul, but it stayed right there in the field of play just in front of home plate. And Jacob Hall able to just pick it up and throw it down to Jaden Jones for the third out in the bottom of the first. So Tuskegee strands two. And we go into the second inning with Benedict leading at 1-0. We'll take a break here on the Golden Tiger Sports Network.
STEM careers are one of the fastest growing fields, yet women of color comprise less than 10% of the workforce within these high-paying jobs. Tuskegee University is changing this. In 2018, we were awarded a grant from the National Science Foundation to develop computer science career awareness for young African American women. In 2019, we established the Campaign for Leadership and Excellence Scholarship. It provides future female engineers with financial support to pursue their educational goals. Today, Tuskegee continues to educate African American women in STEM fields, empowering them to pursue their chosen careers and providing the foundation they need to transform science, medicine, and technology. If a STEM career is in your future, explore what Tuskegee can offer you.
Home, where you hang out with friends, do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
Back live at Washington Field on the campus of Tuskegee University. We go into the second inning now. Benedict back to the plate. They lead it 1-0. Benedict in their top half of the first got a run after a base hit from Mitchell to start the ball game. An error got him to second, and then a sack got him over to third, and eventually on a fly ball or sacrifice was able to come in. So in that first inning, they had one run, one hit, one error by the Golden Tigers, and one left on base. So now it's the pitcher, Farid Mazzell, to step in the box. And Broughton not able to start him off with a strike. That one missing outside. It'll be Mazzell, Jacob Hall, the catcher, and Jaden Jones pop up near third base. Ranging as Hayes says he's got it, backpedals, and he does. So one down here in the top of the first, or the second that is, on the pop-up to the third baseman. It'll be the catcher, Jacob Hall, coming in now to bat. Hall, the sophomore from Powder Springs, Georgia. 333 hitter for the Tigers. Takes the first pitch, grounds it to the shortstop. Coming on is Glass, fires across the diamond, and he got him. Nice job by Glass. Good square target by Evans at first base. So quickly, two outs here in the top of the second. Broughton with a good job of pitching so far. See if he can get this third one out. No, three and out against the Tigers of Benedict. Jaden Jones takes the first pitch for a strike. Jones, a redshirt freshman from Columbia, swings at the first pitch, got a good knock on it back toward the fence, and McPark's not going to hold that one. He has gone deep here at Washington Field. Jaden Jones got a pitch he liked up in the zone and drove it out for the home run. Jones with his first home run of the season for the Tigers of Benedict, and got all of that fastball that Broughton left up in the zone. So Jones with the home run makes it a 2-0 Benedict lead. And Broughton cruising with the first two outs relatively easy in the top of the second. But Jones with that towering shot left side drove it out to make it 2-0. This one hit into the gap right side, and that'll get down for a base hit in right field. Watson circles and pulls back over to first base after the hard hit single right side. So now we go back to the top of the Benedict order. Jamil Mitchell, he singled his first time and scored in the first inning of the ball game. Back over to first base with a pickoff. Close throw there. But Watson able to scramble back in. Mitchell, the left-hander in the box, squares the bunt. High pitch. Hatch faking a throw down to first. One ball to Mitchell, he'll square. Pitch thrown outside for ball two. Two down here, top of the second. Home run by Jones makes it 2-0. Pitch back, pick out at first base again. Watson scrambling back. They are trying to keep him close to the bag. It's a pitch, found the corner there. Make it two balls, one strike. Out, 2-1 from Broughton, that one's low. Good dig out there by Mark Hatch to keep it in front of him and to hold Watson at first base. A rubber match of a three-game set. Doubleheader played on yesterday. They split there. Here comes the pitch. Chopped on and fouled at the plate. So the count is run full now on Mitchell. Top of the second, 3-2 pitch. Pickoff at the first. Watson diving back again. The 3-2, swung on. Bounce it to the second baseman. Gloves flip over the first to retire the side. Nicholas Pratt with an easy ground ball and flip over to Jones for out number three. But the Tigers pick up another run. They do so on the home run by Jaden Jones, his first of the season. Out to left field, they lead it 2-0. Tuskegee trailing, coming to the plate after the timeout.
Home, where you hang out with friends, do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
Are you looking for education that leads to career success and something more? We are Tuskegee University, one of the nation's top-ranked HBCUs. We believe in education to fulfill your purpose. Here, you work hard because you dream harder. By pursuing your purpose, you will make a difference. Are you ready for something big? Let's get started.
Home, where you hang out with friends, do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
We head into the bottom of the second. Tuskegee got some work to do, trailing it 2-0 to the Tigers of Benedict. Tuskegee will send up Cody Willis, Nicholas Pratt, and Mikael Mason in the bottom of the second. Ryan Hayes actually going to be the first batter for Tuskegee here in the bottom of the second. So it's Hayes, Willis, and Pratt, the first three. Mizell with the pitch. That one's low and off the plate. Hayes, 212 batting average, 14 of 66. Takes a pitch high for ball two. Hayes, the senior from Chicago. Watches another one sail out of the zone. Hayes, 10 base on balls in the season. 3-0 count here. Be great to get him aboard. And Mizell finds the zone on that pitch. Down and low with a fastball. 3-1. Chopped on. This one popped up in the center field. Backpedaling. Still backpedaling is Mike Mitchell. Now got a bead on it. And he will glove it for the Tigers of Benedict. As Hayes flies out to center field. So one down here in the bottom of the second for the Golden Tigers. Cody Willis coming into the box. Willis, the junior from Montgomery. 310 batting average for Cody. First pitch on its way. Squared to bunt. And that one low and off the plate. Squared, got it down. Right side, if it'll stay fair. Rolling down the chalk, it did. And runs right into the arms of Jaden Jones. It went down the line, stayed just inside of the chalk. And Jones able to pick it up right there with Willis running right into him. So Jones is retired. So Nicholas Pratt now will come into the box to see if he can get something started with two down here, bottom of the second. Tuskegee trailing it 2-0. Mazzell with the pitch. Pratt takes the first pitch for a strike on the inside corner. Pratt, the freshman from Atlanta, 238 batting average. Leads the team in doubles with seven. Swings at a pitch, popped it up. It's going to stay on the infield. And it'll be Mizell, the pitcher, coming away with it. Jones was there, but as Pratt was running down the line, he had to break off his route, and Mizell was there to cover with the catch. So Tuskegee sends up three, and they come away with three up and three down, and Benedict still leads it 2-0. We go to the top of the third. We'll do that after this timeout on the Golden Tigers Sports Network.
Hey, future business leader. Launch your success story at one of the nation's premier HBCUs. Learn cutting-edge practices and feed your entrepreneurial spirit. Tuskegee University. We get the business of business education. Hey, future business leader, launch your success story at one of the nation's premier HBCUs. Learn cutting-edge practices and feed your entrepreneurial spirit. Tuskegee University, we get the business of business education.
Send up McDuffie, Murray, and Bates to start the top third. McDuffie. Rounded out, first time around. Swings at the first pitch, and circling to his left is Mason with the grab for Tuskegee. So one pitch, one out for Broughton here in the top of the third. Murray on the bat now. Swings at a pitch and fouls it at the plate. Murray drew a walk in the first inning. Stole a base and got over to third on a wild pitch. And that's where the side was retired with him at third base. He did get a run in that inning, though. They lead it right now 2-0. And right now, Broughton behind in the count, 3-1. Bates on deck for Benedict. Here's the pitch from Kyrie. Good pitch there. Brings the count to full to 3-2. That one off the plate, and Murray takes another walk. That's his second of the ball game. So Murray aboard with one down. Shortstop Taj Bates stepping in. So Broughton having to go to the stretch once again. Murray stole a base last time. Curveball missed the plate for ball one. Good job there by Hatch behind the plate to keep it in front of him. All right. The pitch. Swung on. Bates ripped it down the left field line, but foul. With Murray down at first base. One pitch. The pitch up. Pick off at first, and he got him at first base. Murray leaning too far out. And Broughton with a good move to first. Got him on a pickoff. So picked off at first base with Murray. And then count at 2-1. Chance for Broughton to come out of this inning. That pitch is low. Count 2-3-1 now. So Murray stole that first base in the first inning. Was trying to do the same. Got caught leaning. This one swatted on and foul again down the third base line. Bait grounded out to third his last time up. And change of speed there on that pitch by Broughton. On a 3-2. Full count. Here's a pitch. That one's low and in the dirt. So Bates draws a walk, the second of the inning. Drew one but got picked off at first base. So now Isaiah Canty, the left fielder, will come on. Bates at first, pitch from Broughton. Good sweeping curve across the zone for strike number one. Canty popped up to the first baseman, Jones, his last time up. This one at eye level and out of the zone. Take the count to 1-1. This one ripped up into center field, backpedaling to its left. Is Mason, he's there, squares up and makes the catch. So that'll bring the top of the third to an end for the Tigers of Benedict. They put two runners on by virtue of a walk, but no damage done to Tuskegee. They still trail it 2-0. They will come to play in the bottom of the third. It'll be Broughton, Hatch, and Glass, the first three. We'll see them right after this timeout.
Are you looking for education that leads to career success and something more? We are Tuskegee University, one of the nation's top-ranked HBCUs. We believe in education to fulfill your purpose. Here, you work hard because you dream harder. By pursuing your purpose, you will make a difference. Are you ready for something big? Let's get started.
Home, where you hang out with friends, do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
Overcast clouds here in Tuskegee, but baseball still rolling on here at Washington Field. Tuskegee trailing it 2-0 to the Tigers of Benedict in this rubber match between the teams. And our broadcast coverage of Tuskegee baseball on the Golden Tiger Sports Network is brought to you by TNT and Fireworks, America's best-selling brand of and the largest distributor of consumer fireworks. TNT Fireworks, proud supporter of Tuskegee Athletics. Bottom of the third we go. Michael Mason sitting in the box now. The lefty Mizell fires the first pitch. Mason squared for the bunt, pulled the bat back, and Mizell threw a strike to get things started in this set. That pitch below the knees of Mason, count to 1-1. Bottom of the third, Mason. Last batter in that Tuskegee lineup to start the third. That one thrown high for 2-1. Two-one pitch now from Mizell. Mason squares, swings at it and misses. Comes up empty there. What a good fastball there from Mizell. Count even at 2-2. Mizell looks at a ball close to that strike zone, but took a good pitch, and the count goes to 3-2. Three-two on its way. Swings, Mizell, or Mason does, pops it up. Ranging that one may get out of play, and it will, just near our broadcast trailer behind the Benedict bench. Eric Tabor hunkered down in that trailer over there. Guess he's okay. Didn't see that soft baseball rattle around in there. We'll check on him later. 3-2 pitch. This one hit in the field of play and through left side for a base hit. Good piece of hitting there by Mikhail Mason. Mason worked the count to full and got a knocker down between short and third. He's aboard. Now they go back to the top of the order, the Tigers do. Kyrie Brockman set to come to the plate. Mark Hatch to follow. Nobody out here in the bottom of the third. Good start to the half inning. Mason with the single left side. Broughton singled to start the Tuskegee offense in the top of the first. Mizell with the pitch. Slow pitch on run now. Sliding into second base, stolen there by Mikhail Mason. Mason got a great jump off the pitcher, Mizell. And able to steal that. So he's down to second on the steal. Now, Broughton with a runner in scoring position. Long look back to second by Mizell. Now to the plate. Curveball, got it to fall in. Just on the inside corner of the plate. Broughton trying to pick up his fourth RBI of the season here, if he can find an empty spot. Nobody down. Bottom of the third. Pitch whacked out to center field. A couple of steps back is Mitchell. He'll grab it there. And Mason does not have a chance to tag on that one. Mark Hatch to set in now on the plate. Fly out to center by Broughton. One down. Mason remains at second base. See, he's trying to see if they can't pick him up to bring him around. Throw down to second. And Mason back easily. On the season, Tuskegee coming into this ball game having left 233 men on base during the course of the season. Their first 35 ball games. Don't want to fall victim of that here. Here's the pitch. And taking a strike was Hatch from Mizell. Mason got a board on a single. And then he stole second base. Curveball by Mizell. That one's off the plate. Big looping curve on that pitch, but did not find the range. Two balls, one strike. One down, bottom of the third. Tuskegee trailing by two. Chance to pick up at least one here in this inning. Inside pitch there, real tight. Good eye there inside by Hatch. Three-one, base is open. Chopper back up to the pitcher. Mizell looks to third, but takes DeShure out at first base. And on the crack of the bat, Mason was moving, so they did not have a chance to get him at third. So he's at third. And Hatch is retired. So Mason over the third now on the fielder's choice. Alex Glass in the box. Glass lined out hard to center field his last time up. Nothing to show for it. But now in a position with Mason at third, and find a gap here to get that first Tuskegee run of the day. Mizell with the pitch. Looping curve up high though, out of the zone. Two and oh count to Alex Glass, the shortstop. Mizell with a strike there. Glass taking all the way on that pitch. Now the count at 2-1. He'll go active with the bat here. A 2-1 by Mizell. Curveball. And he got Glass way out in front of that. Glass obviously sitting dead fastball there. And he got that curve. Good pitch selection there by Hall and Mizell delivering on it. Count at 2-2. Two pitch. That one bounced up there and gets away. And that'll bring Mason home easily for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee for their first run of the ball game. That one will go down as a wild pitch. And there, Mason able to just trot in for Tuskegee. Tuskegee's on the board now, trailing it 2-1. Glass in the box. 3-2 count he faces with two down. Three, two by Mizell. That one low and in the dirt. Good look there by Glass at the plate to draw that walk. So he's aboard, and that'll bring up the right fielder, Harrison Barnes. Barnes drew a base on balls in the first inning. The left on left matchup, the second time in the contest. Glass at first. Here's the pitch from Mizell. Inside corner, he found it for strike number one. Two down here in the bottom of the third. Tuskegee has scored. It's 2-1 now. That one got some, allowed Barnes to stretch his arms there, but he fouled it off just to our left. They're trying to stay in tight on him. Kind of squeeze and pinch him inside with those longer arms that he's got. He's a rangy player. Down in the count, 0-2. Stayed alive at the plate. That one will bounce foul. So Glass back to first. Barnes back into the box. Playing Barnes at regular depth, the outfield is. And no shift on the infield either. Here's the 2-2 pitch swung on and foul tip to stay alive. Cowan is still at 0-2, but a good battle here by Barnes, despite being in the hole on the count. More pitches he gets to see from the lefty. May be able to dive into something. Throw over the first. Token throw there as Glass slides back in, or just trots back in at first base. Wasn't too far off the bag anyway. O2 pitch from Mizell as he peers at first base, goes to the plate. This one driven deep left field, want to stay in play, and he hooked it just foul. So Barnes gave it a ride, but it would not stay in the field of play. Would have been over the right fielder's head, McDuffie. But just not enough real estate to keep it fair. So we'll reset it. Count remains 0-2, two down, bottom of the third. The pitch, call strike three. Good battle there by Barnes, but he took that pitch on the outside where Mizell found the corner for the strikeout. So Barnes is retired, and so is Tuskegee at the bottom of the third. But the good news is Tuskegee able to get their first score of the ball game. After the base hit by Mason, a wild pitch, and then a wild pitch at home got him to score for the Golden Tigers. So we go to the fourth now. Tuskegee cutting that deficit 2-1. Tigers of Benedict coming up to the plate.
What does education mean when you choose the top HBCU in Alabama?
So one of the things that's been most valuable for my experience at Tuskegee is being able to face challenges head on. I can definitely say here I've learned how to be an advocate for myself, how to speak up, and how to present myself in ways that can help me get opportunities, that help me fix things that may not be right. And I think that's really just the best skill that I've learned here that I can take with me for the rest of my life.
Look forward to your bright future. Apply to Tuskegee University today.
Hey, future business leader. Launch your success story at one of the nation's premier HBCUs. Learn cutting-edge practices and feed your entrepreneurial spirit. Tuskegee University. We get the business of business education.
Back live at Washington Field, Tuskegee cutting into that Benedict lead 2-1 now as we start the fourth. Tigers of Benedict will be sending up Mizell, Hall, and Jones to start the top of their fourth. So it's pitcher on pitcher now. Kyrie Broughton and Fareed Mizell into the box. Mizell popped up to the third baseman. His first time through the order. And the first pitch in this sequence is a ball. Broughton quickly working, fires a curveball on the outside. Got Mizell to chase. Count goes to 1-1. Same area. This one bounced down the left, right to the first baseman. And Evans Jones able to just collect it there. Trot to the bag for out number one. So Broughton retires Mizell. And it'll be the catcher, Jacob Hall, coming in to bat. Hall grounded out to the shortstop his last time up. And Broughton starts him out with a strike. Middle of the plate. Kyrie working quickly in this inning. Diving down the line. That'll clear for a base hit. Just out of the outstretched arms of Ryan Hayes, diving at the bag at third. So a hard hit ball by Hall will put him aboard. So Hall gets on. And Jaden Jones now will come to the plate. He homered his last time up. Inside, and it stayed there. Thought that one might have drifted back over across the plate, but no call. It's ball one instead. On the pitch, the runner going. Throw down the second is offline. And the base stolen there by Hall.
Come on, big man, drive another one. Come on, Jason. Catch another one.
So Hall pushed down the second with one down. The count even, one and one on Jones. That one just a little bit off the plate from Kyrie. Count at 2-1. Broughton peering back to second base. Now comes with the pitch. This one ripped again out this left center field, and again, Park just not large enough to hold it. As Jones has gone back-to-back home runs for Benedict. Got a pitch up in the zone and just drilled it deep between center and left field for his second home run of the day. Back-to-back for Jaden Jones, and he clears the bases with that one. So he has found his rhythm here at Washington Park as he goes deep for the second time. And he extends that Benedict lead to 4-1. Broughton started the afternoon this inning off in good shape, retiring the pitcher. Then he gave up a single, sharp single past third base, and the second home run of the ball game for Jaden Jones. Squaring to bunt now is Amarion Watson. Watson singled his last time to the plate for Benedict. Jones has cleared the bags. Benedict with a 4-1 lead. Now Hatch can take an opportunity to go out and talk to senior pitcher Kyrie Broughton. So after that conference, Broughton brings it to the plate. That was called a strike. He brings it to count to 2-2, or to 2-1 after that strike. This one ripped out to deep center field, giving chase. It'll stay in the park, but well over the head of Mason, who has to run it down at the base of the fence line. And it's a stand-up double there for Watson. So Watson 2 of 2 in the ball game. That one a double out to center field.
Come on, top order. Time to do something now.
So we go back to the top of the order now for the Tigers of Benedict. Center fielder Jamil Mitchell. Looking for his first hit of the ball game. Or he had one in the first inning, beg your pardon, to start things off. They're looking for a second. Here's the pitch. Off the plate and low by Broughton. That one bounced up there. Good defensive effort by Hatch behind the plate to smother it. Pitch. That one off the plate. Oh, they call that a strike there. Late call, but a strike called, and that'll bring it to 2-1. Benedict was trying to actually execute a bunt there. Two-one pitch. This one ripped out to left field to get a guy to get down there for a base hit. Willis could only wait for it to bounce, but too much ground to try to cover, to try to come in and get it. So he let it bounce in front of him. So Mitchell with his second hit of the ball game. He's aboard at first. And that will push Watson over to third. Runners at the corners now. And McDuffie's in the box. This one popped up, ranging toward the Tuskegee bench, hustling over there in traffic. And I think it hit something there. I think it may have hit the tree line. So a dead ball, and they'll reset it. Giving chase over there with Ryan Hayes. Hatch quickly from behind the plate, sprint it over there as well. Not sure if Hayes had it, but it did hit the branch of the tree over there, and it fell right down to him. 0-1, pickoff at first base. Back in there safe at first. Runners at the corners. The pitch going, throw. They try to go right to the shortstop to fake it down to the second. To try to get Watson to believe it was going to be a throw all the way down. But the base is stolen, and Watson stays put at third. Two pitch. That one just missed. So the count now to 1-2. Runners at third and second for Benedict. They lead it 4-1. Broughton curveball just missed the zone on that one. Not a bad pitch in that situation. Trying to see if they couldn't get McDuffie to chase that one. Tuskegee trying to minimize the damage in this top of the fourth. Already two played at four, Benedict, on the home run by Jaden Jones. That was his second of the ball game. 2-2 pitch. Curveball. Got him on the corner. Good pitch there by Kyrie. The strikeout, McDuffie. A big needed strikeout for Tuskegee as well. So two down now in the top of the fourth. Justin Murray back to the plate. Murray has walked twice in his two plate appearances in this ball game. Watson at third, Mitchell at second. Pitch, that's in for a strike. So Broughton found the zone there and has found it the last couple of pitches. Curveball there, good one by Kyrie there as well. Followed up that fastball with the curveball to the inside. So gave Murray a completely different look on that pitch. Broughton ahead in the count, 0-2. Two down, and here's the pitch. Mighty close, no call. One ball, two strikes. One, two from the senior. That one's low. Good block there by Mark Hatch from behind the plate. So the count even at 2-2 now. Kyrie trying to minimize damage with a good pitch here. The 2-2 on its way. And eyeball level there to Murray, so the count pushed to 2-3-2 full. Got a base open here on a 3-2. That one chopped up the middle and through for a base hit. And that'll bring the two runners for Benedict home. Watson and Mitchell, they score on the single up the middle by Justin Murray. Murray just hit it right back where it came from, didn't overpower it, but found it right up the middle for the base hit. So he'll pick up two RBIs on that and clear the bases for Benedict. And they stretch their lead now to 6-1. Shortstop Todd Bates in the box. Murray already taking off the second base. Throw down this time on that side of the bag, and they got him. Finally got a good throw down there to Hatch, and Hatch is able to pick off Murray called stealing. So that'll bring the top of the fourth to a close. But the Benedict Tigers extend their lead. They pick up four in the frame, and they lead it now 6-1 over the Tigers of Tuskegee. And we'll get set for Tuskegee to come to the plate after this break.
Tuskegee University's founder, Booker T. Washington, said, "Excellence is to do a common thing in an uncommon way. At many universities, big classes are common. Not at Tuskegee. We have small classes with a 14-to-1 average student-to-teacher ratio. This formula for excellence ensures individualized attention. You get to know your professors, and they get to know you well enough to recommend you for internships, research, graduate programs, and job opportunities. Small classes, big impact. It's all part of educational excellence at Tuskegee University."
Hometown Ticketing makes it fast and easy to buy tickets on your school's website or in the new Hometown Fan app. It's simple. Just search for your school, buy your tickets, and they'll be right there in your account, ready to be scanned when you get to your event. Download the Hometown Fan app today.
Back live at Washington Field, Benedict has extended the lead to 6-1 after a four-run top of the fourth. And Tuskegee now coming to bat. Got to get something going, sustained offense. We'll see what they can do with Evans Jones leading off to start the bottom of the fourth. He'll be followed by Ryan Hayes and center fielder Cody Willis, the top three for Tuskegee in the bottom of the fourth. Evans takes a whack at the first pitch from Mizell and comes up empty. Evans left that little dribbler in front of the plate his last time up. And Hall able to throw him out at first base. That pitch low and in the dirt, so the count goes to 1-1. Heavy gray cloud now just hanging over the top of Washington Field at this point. 1-1 pitch, that one's low and inside. Weather forecast had the rain pushing out around noontime. That part of the forecast was true. It did clear out. They just didn't say anything about it coming back. That one off the plate with the fastball. And the count now 3-1 to the first baseman, Evan Jones. Three-one pitch. That one whacked out to left field for a base hit and down by Evans Jones. That one up a little bit in the zone, but Jones able to just clobber it out to left field to get aboard. So good start to the bottom of the fourth for the Golden Tigers. Ryan Hayes now stepping in. Hayes flew out to center field his last time up. Evans at first. First pitch to Hayes. That one's up and out of the zone. That one popped up left field. Coming on is Canty. He'll make the grab for the Tigers of Benedict. So one down here in the bottom of the fourth. Take a look at what we were talking about just a few moments ago. You see the radar for the Tuskegee area as we take a look at baseball and radar. Whoa, we're getting sophisticated, aren't we? But that's a nice look in terms of where we are and what's actually being forecast coming for this area. Nice job from the truck there. Mizell starts out ahead on Willis with a fastball. 0-1 count. Jones at first base. And that one finds the mark. A little bit of off-speed action there by Mizell on the pitch. And he's quickly ahead 0-2 on Cody Willis. And that's chin music there as Willis has to back out of there. Count goes to 1-2. That one hit out to center field, coming on quickly and trying to make a lunge and catch. And he does. Good effort by Jamil Mitchell out in center field for the Tigers of Benedict. Had to come in and come in a hurry. That baseball was dying quickly. And able to extend it and slide on it and make the catch sliding in center field. So two down here for Tuskegee in the bottom of the fourth. As Willis lines out to the center field. And that'll bring on second baseman Nicholas Pratt. Pratt looks at a ball down low, spits on it for ball one. Evans still at first for Tuskegee. Started the inning off with a single to left field. 1-0 pitch, that's in for a strike. One ball, one strike. Pratt readies. Here's the pitch. That one inside. Got behind the catcher. Throw down to second. That one's high, and the base is stolen. Hall couldn't find it. It was right behind him. And that allows Jones to go down to second base. He's going to go down past ball there. So Jones out there. Pratt chance to pick him up with a single. Pratt rips one deep left field. Park won't hold that one. He knocks it out of here. Driven deep to left. Nicholas Pratt brings home two on the home run left field. Boy, he hit that a ton. Had it not hit one of those trees, there's no telling if that baseball would still be flying. Pratt knocked the cover off of that one for Tuskegee. So Pratt with the homer. Pratt, that's his first home run of the season. That's a two-bagger for Pratt. And Tuskegee again cutting into that lead. So Pratt with the home run here in the bottom of the fourth to clear the bases. He scores and he brings home Evans as well. So he'll pick up two RBI on that home run to left field.
All right, guys, let's go, let's go, let's go.
Okay, old Mason now stepping in the box. Lead cut in half after that two-run shot by Pratt left field. Mason. Count to 2-1 on Mason now. Two down here in the bottom of the fourth. But Tuskegee has struck for two in this set. Mason rips another one left field. Deep headed toward the fence and over for the home run. So Mason goes back to back with Pratt. That was a rocket line drive by Mason that got out of here in a hurry. And Tuskegee in a hurry to try to come back in this baseball game. Back-to-back knockers left field. Mason with his home run. And just like that, the deficit to two. Back-to-back home runs by the Golden Tigers. And Kyrie Broughton on the pitcher at the plate to bat. Beg your pardon. First pitch in there for a strike by Mizell. Another curveball, same result. 0-2 to the pitcher Broughton. Probably nobody happier about those back-to-back home runs than Kyrie Broughton. Bring his squad within two. That one bounced up there by Mizell. Make it 1-1. Curveball short of the plate. Curveball, this time he fools Broughton on it for out number three. That brings us to the end of the fourth. Tuskegee cuts the deficit to 6-4. Take a break here. More baseball action just ahead.
Are you looking for education that leads to career success and something more? We are Tuskegee University, one of the nation's top-ranked HBCUs. We believe in education to fulfill your purpose. Here, you work hard because you dream harder. By pursuing your purpose, you will make a difference. Are you ready for something big? Let's get started.
Tuskegee University's founder, Booker T. Washington, said, "Excellence is to do a common thing in an uncommon way." At many universities, big classes are common. Not at Tuskegee. We have small classes with a 14-to-1 average student-to-teacher ratio. This formula for excellence ensures individualized attention. You get to know your professors, and they get to know you. Know you well enough to recommend you for internships, research, graduate programs, and job opportunities. Small classes, big impact. It's all part of educational excellence at Tuskegee University.
Things tightening up again here at Washington Field, Tuskegee. Pitching across three runs in the bottom of the fourth to make it 6-4 deficit. Benedict back to the plate. The Tuskegee bats coming alive in that bottom of the fourth. Back-to-back home runs in that inning. Nicholas Pratt went deep first. The two-run homer followed by Mikael Mason. With a one-run homer to make it the 6-4 deficit. And Tuskegee now going with a finally pulled Broughton out of the lineup from the mound and going with a new pitcher here to start the fifth. We'll make out that pitcher for you in just a moment. Benedict will be sending up Canty, Mizell, and Hall. And looks like that's going to be Mikael Mason coming in from center field to take the mound now for the Tigers of Tuskegee. Kyrie Broughton took Tuskegee to 4.5. And we get set to start the fifth. Bates coming back to the plate as Murray is caught stealing to end the fourth for Benedict. So Bates back in the box. Takes the first pitch high from Mason for ball one. That pitch by Mason thrown high as well. Trying to see if he can't find that range for the plate. Oh, 2-1 Bates. Bates drew a walk back in the third. And Mason behind in the count. 3 balls. Can't find that range yet. 4 straight balls by Mason. And Bates draws a walk to start the fifth. So he's aboard. And Isaiah Canty. He will step in. Flew out to center field his last time up in the third. Mason to go from the stretch now. Fires to the plate, got his first strike of the contest with that pitch. Bates, 5 of 6 in terms of stolen bases for Benedict. Pass ball by Mason, brushes Canty back. One and one on the count. That one thrown high. Good effort by Hatch to go airborne to get to save that one from coming to the backstop. Two and one to count on Canty. Nobody out here in the top of this fifth for Benedict. There's a pitch and this one nails Canty in the back. So a walk, now a hit batsman puts 2 on for Benedict to start the fifth. Take another look at that radar for the area. And looks like we may have had some good fortune here. Looks like that rain indicator shows it's kind of going past us here in Tuskegee. And do see the clouds lightening up just a bit as that big gray cloud kind of makes a little bit of movement away from the campus. See some sunlight back to the west of us, so. Our southwest of us. And right now, a cloud looming right over the field here. Back-to-back walks to the Tigers of Benedict. Tuskegee with a good offensive showing in the bottom of the fourth, but trailing at 6-4. Put 2 runners on early here in the top of the fifth. Don't want to give them the runs right back that you worked so hard for with the back-to-back home runs. Give it right back to them. Visit to the mound there by Coach Jones. So Mizell will step in the box. As Mason continues to work to find the strike zone. Bates down at second. Canty, who was hit by a pitch is at first. Bates got on with a walk. This one closer to the zone and a strike there by Mason. Likely that conversation about not overthrowing the baseball. Settle in, throw strikes, and let's see what the defense can do. Mason answered with that first pitch, which was a strike. That one located off the plate. Lower in terms of the zone. One and one on the count. One pitch. Nice stop behind the dish by Hatch. Two balls, one strike to Mizell. Over but low on that pitch. Count to 3-1. Swatted back up the middle. Shortstop picks it up, fires across the diamond. Good for the double play. Nice job there by Alex Glass to slide to his left and field that ball. Took it to second himself and to throw on the first for the double play. Tuskegee certainly needed that double play. So Mizell hits into the double play. So the base is cleared now, or at third base, it's Bates after the double play with two down. Hall takes a strike there from Mason. So McHale makes it the count 1-1 with that strike. Be great if Tuskegee can come out of this thing unscathed. That one swung on just over the head of Scooping. Left side with the throw. Did he get him? No, he came off the base. Great effort there by Glass at shortstop to field that baseball behind second base. Was raising to try to throw it across his body. Got a good throw over there, but the throw pulled Jones off the bag. And that will plate Bates from third. And at first base, it'll be Hall. With that first, with the base hit. Great effort there by Alex Glass at short. Jaden Jones has been a Tuskegee killer this afternoon. Back-to-back home runs for him in the ball game. And here in the top of the fifth with a man at first. Step off and throw over. And Hall is back. Jones homered in the second, and he homered in the fourth. Here's a pitch. This one ripped on the grass and to the shortstop, and no throw there. Had to come all the way across the diamond there, and he was in the hole left side. So Jaden Jones' perfect day continues with a single left side. Just hit it there in the hole at third, past the third baseman Hayes, and Glass angling to his right. The ball so deep in the hole, got to it, but just could not get a throw. So Jones is aboard. Marion Watson now into the box for Benedict. That one on the inside. Good location there by Mason, just a bit off the plate. Hall at second, Jones at first, two down, top of the fifth. Good pitch there by Mikel for a strike. Counted 1-1. That one's over but low. So 2-1 on the count. Now the 2-1 offering from Mason. Strike on the inside corner. Count even at 2-2. Hall at second, Jones at first for Benedict. Mason with the pitch, bounced it up there, gets away. Got away from Hatch. And the runners advance 90 feet. It'll go down as a wild pitch to advance both runners. Count goes to 3-2. And that's ball four to Watson. So Watson is aboard. So the base is loaded now. And they go back to the top of the order, Benedict does. Jamil Mitchell, the center fielder, squares at the plate. Takes the first pitch for a strike. Hall at first, Jones down at second. Swing and a miss there by Mitchell. Watson at first for Benedict. 0-2. Crowd wanted that call, didn't get it. It's ball instead. One ball, two strikes. Nowhere to put anybody now. Mikel with the 1-2. That one off the plate. Oh, they throw the baseball, got away from Mason on the mound. But didn't run roll far enough. Glass, luckily, saw it and able to stop it there. Runner certainly could have advanced it, gotten by him. 2-2 pitch. Way off the plate there with that pitch. So a count goes to full now. Count. Runners will certainly be moving on this pitch. Base is loaded, 3-2 on its way. And that one thrown high for ball four. So Mitchell draws the walk. And he'll pick up the RBI as Hall comes to the plate. So now it's Jones at third, Watson at second, and Mitchell over at first. And right fielder Jalen McDuffie will make a plate appearance. First pitch strike there by Mason. Just got to stop falling behind. Starts to sequence well. Just got to finish that one up high. Got a good live arm. Just got to keep that ball in the strike zone, though, closer to it. That one thrown up high as well. Well, seems to be reverting back to what was the problem early on when he took over on the mound, overthrowing it just a bit. No doubt frustration setting in with the walks. Just got to settle in mentally and give the batter something to offer at. Closer there, but off the plate to 3-1. And Tuskegee now got some pitchers stirring in the bullpen down to our left. Count at 3-1. That one ripped on and ripped foul off to the left. Count goes to 3-2. So Mason here with another big pitch on a 3-2, bases loaded. Runners on the way, the pitch off the plate for a walk. So back-to-back walks. This time it's McDuffie who gets walked. And Jones will come to the plate to score. So Tuskegee now taking time for the conference. Looks like they're going to make a call to the bullpen, and they will. So Mason just not able to close out this inning. Got it to two outs. Gave up a series of walks. It looks like this will be LeBron Stinson, the junior from Atlanta, who will take over at the mound. So Mikel Mason, obviously disappointed in the performance on the mound. Such a big role he was playing in terms of Tuskegee trying to mount that comeback when he hit that home run in the last inning. So it will be Stinson. Stinson, a junior from Atlanta. This will be his seventh appearance for Tuskegee. Started two ball games, only 12 innings pitched overall. He's given up 20 hits, 20 runs. And of those 20 runs, 15 have been earned runs. 8 strikeouts on the season. He's given up 3 doubles and 1 home run on the season for Tuskegee. So we'll see what the junior from Atlanta can do in terms of trying to get this final out of this tough fifth inning for Tuskegee. Had it to down to 6-4. But a series of walks in this inning. Played at 3 already for Benedict. And they're back up to a 9-4 lead. Tuskegee University National Athletic Alumni Association is a proud sponsor of our broadcast coverage of Golden Tigers Athletics. To find out how you can join the elite group of supporters of Tuskegee University Athletics, visit the Tuskegee University National Athletic Association website at www.tuskegee.edu/TUNAA. That's tuskegee.edu/TUNNA. And get all the information you need to become a member of TUNA. And we certainly thank them for their support of our coverage of Tuskegee Athletics. Murray back into the box now for Benedict. Good. Watson, Mitchell, and McDuffie on the bags. First pitch, this one ripped to the shortstop. It's a high hop. He's got to play it off the hop. Fires across the diamond, not in time. Gets away from the first baseman, Jones, but he's able to run it down. Nothing Glass could do there. He had to wait for that ball to come down. Got on the edge of the dirt with the hop of the baseball, and it just sprung right up. So Murray will pick up the base hit and pick up the RBI as Watson was able to score on his single. Now he's on the base. So now it's Mitchell, Duffy, and Murray on the bags. Stenson trying to get this second out. Here's a pitch. That's a call, strike one. Bates back up at the plate. He started this inning for Benedict. Count to 2-1. Now the sun finally breaking out here in Tuskegee after that big gray cloud pushed on. Stenson trying to keep it to the inside, but in too tight there to take the count to 3-1. That one in tight as well, and Bates draws the walk. So Bates with his second walk of the fifth inning. So he's aboard, and they push another runner across. That was Mitchell scoring after the walk of Bates. Was first pitch in the sequence to Isaiah Canty. And that one's off the plate. So it's McDuffie, Murray, and Bates on the base pads now for Canty. Canty lifts it down. That'll get down and maybe the gap in the right field. Certainly going to at least play two there. He slides in the second with a double. And holding at third base is Bates for the Tigers of Benedict. So the double into left field by Canty. And he'll pick up two RBIs as McDuffie and Murray score. Bates held at third. And still two down here in the top of the fifth. Kurt Ball, that one's off the plate. Mizell. Hit into a double play at the beginning of this inning, which was very encouraging for Tuskegee, but this time he's going the opposite way with the ball. And Mizell gets it down to the fence line. He'll be digging for two after that ball down in the left corner. And he cleared the bases for Benedict. So Mizell really helping his own cause on the mound now with that double to left. So he gets the two-bagger and picks up two RBI in the process. And just like that, with Tuskegee having cut it to 6-4, the lead balloons for Benedict to 15-4. And two down and top of the fifth, with still a runner on board at second base, the pitcher and designated hitter, Mizell. At the plate is Jacob Hall for the second time in this inning. He singled his last time up. Would come around and score. This one's ripped out the left. And this time that's a diving catch nicely done there by Cody Willis out in the left field to finally end this damage that was done to Tuskegee in the top of the fifth by Benedict. So Benedict put across 9 in this inning and they extend their lead to 15-4 over Tuskegee. As we go to the bottom half of the fifth, stay with us on the Golden Tiger Sports Network.
Are you looking for education that leads to career success and something more? We are Tuskegee University, one of the nation's top-ranked HBCUs. We believe in education to fulfill your purpose. Here, you work hard because you dream harder. By pursuing your purpose, you will make a difference. Are you ready for something big? Let's get started.
Academy Sports and Outdoors makes it easy to get what you need and have fun out there. Get free shipping at academy.com or get free curbside or in-store pickup at your Academy store.
Severe damage done to Tuskegee in that top of the fifth by the Golden Tigers, or the Tigers of Benedict College. They bat around in the inning, and they pick up 9 runs in that top of the fifth. Tuskegee just so close, having worked so hard the prior inning with the back-to-back home runs to make it close. And just a scoring eruption by Benedict to answer. See if Tuskegee has the same in them in the bottom half of their fifth inning. Just a rocker there, though. While the skies are clear here in the Tuskegee area, certainly it's not as clear on the ground. As clear as Tuskegee had cut it to 2. And then Benedict just able to rain down runs in the top of the fifth to extend it to 15-4. So Tuskegee got to regroup and try to resettle into it. They will send up the catcher, Mark Hatch, to start things here in the bottom of the fifth. Mizell still on the mound for Benedict. He just doubled in their half of this inning. Fires a strike there. He's well rested and comfortable with that lead. So he should be pitching at his absolutely best here with no pressure in terms of the lead. It's a big one. Same spot there on that pitch by Mizell. Quickly ahead on Hatch. 0-2. Hatch looking for his first base hit of the ball game. Fouls this one off. And at the fence line, out of play. Giving chase was Jones, Jaden Jones, for Benedict, just by their bench and near our production truck. We didn't go off air, so I'm assuming, Eric, you're okay in there, right? 0-2. Bounced up there and hit Hatch on his way back up. That's a break Tuskegee will certainly take. So Hatch is aboard after being hit by a pitch. And in a situation where Mizell would be a lot more relaxed than that and not have to even come that close to a batter. So Hatch is aboard. And here comes the shortstop, Alex Glass. Alex looks at the first pitch for a strike. 11 certainly is not impossible. Throw over the first. And Hatch is back. One pitch. Curveball bounces up there. And it'll get away from Hall momentarily. And that will send Hatch down to second on the wild pitch. So Mizell causing problems for himself. Hit my Hatch to send them to first base. This one chopped out, short hopper to third. Tough play across the diamond with the throw. Murray is there, and sliding and taking third on the play was Hatch. It was a slow roller toward Murray at third, but he was able to field and fire over the first for the out. And then Hatch took third on the throw. So Barnes at the plate now with Hatch at third. One down, bottom of the fifth. Left-left matchup here. Curveball, floated, and out of the zone. Mizell struck out Barnes the last time they met. And he takes a strike there. Mizell ahead in the count now. Our count even at 1-1 after that pitch from Mizell. That one shot right back up the middle for a base hit. RBI there by Harrison Barnes. Barnes with a hard rip on the baseball, knocked it right out to center field. So he is aboard on the single, and he picks up the RBI, driving in Mark Hatch. There's nothing impossible. As the first baseman, Evan Jones, steps in now. One down here, bottom of the fifth. Harrison at first. Hatch already driven in. Slow curve ball off the plate. That one by Mizell. Better spot it. That's good for a strike. Jones singled his last time up. Takes back-to-back pitches for strikes from Mizell. One ball, two strikes. And that one off the plate. Evan with a good eye on that pitch. Steps back in with a 2-2 count. Ripped down the between right and left, and it finally got down. They were giving chase down there. McDuffie and Mitchell wasn't clear if either was going to wave off the other, and it just finally fell in between the two of them with McDuffie chasing and Mitchell chasing. So that'll go in as a clean base hit. And now that'll bring in Ryan Hayes, the third baseman, with two men out there. Barnes aboard, and Jones now aboard. Back-to-back singles for Tuskegee. Hayes with a chance for some RBIs if he can make something happen with the stick. Hayes flew out to left field his last time up. And in the second inning, flew out to center field. Barnes at second. Evan Jones at first. Tuskegee already has pushed across one here in the bottom of the fifth. A good pitch there from Mizell. Hayes taking all the way on that pitch. O-2, out of the strike zone and high. Yeah. Mizell set for the 1-2. On its way. Curveball dipped too low. Inside. Count goes to 2-2. Hayes with 8 RBI on the season. Takes a look at the ball outside the zone. And the count runs to 3-2 now. Three-two pitch here. That one off the plate and gets away. So Hayes draws the walk. And now the base is loaded for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. And the left fielder, Cody Willis, stepping into the box, lined out hard to center field his last time up. Love to get something in the gap here. Clear those bases. Bases loaded for Willis. Mizell. First pitch in the sequence. That one off the plate. Willis with a good eye there. The layoff of that pitch. Barnes at third, Jones at second, Hayes at first. And that one in for a strike from Mizell. Count at 1-1. Yeah. Willis wasn't fooled his last time up. This time, curveball by Mizell. Had Willis out front. Hit that last line drive to center field extremely hard. But he's behind now in the count 1-2. I'm going to get something in play here. Deep fly out or a base hit. Instead takes call strike three. Willis just not able to get the bat off his shoulder on that pitch. So Mizell needed a big strike out there, and he got it there to bring it to two outs. Nick Pratt, he has gone deep in this ball game. Would love to do it with the bases full here. Went deep in the fourth. Here's a pitch, curveball, way out in front of that one was Nicholas. Strike one. Pratt drove in two on his home run in the fourth. He'd love to do a five spot here, or four spot. Five overall. Curveball in there by Mizell. Way down in the count, 0-2. Here's the pitch. That one off the plate, low. One ball, two strikes. Bases loaded for Tuskegee. Pitch from Mizell. Curveball, and he got it over. Good pitch there from Mizell to work his way out of some severe damage there, giving up only one run in the bottom of the fifth to Tuskegee. And Tuskegee will leave the bases loaded to end this inning. They get one. The lead 15-5 now for the Tigers of Benedict. We'll take a break. And
Hometown Ticketing makes it fast and easy to buy tickets on your school's website or in the new Hometown Fan app. It's simple. Just search for your school, buy your tickets, and they'll be right there in your account, ready to be scanned when you get to your event. Download the Hometown Fan app today.
As a global bank, our game plan is to help clients manage their money. We're a team of challengers, thinkers, and go-getters. Together, we bring out the best in each other. With our partner SIAC, we're creating pathways for the next generation of talent. We're scouting bankers, advisors, techies, and yes, athletes. Kick off your career with UBS.
Back live at Washington Field on the campus of Tuskegee University. Tuskegee trailing the Tigers of Benedict in this rubber game match between the teams. They met yesterday, split a doubleheader. Tuskegee had it down to 6-4 going into the fifth. And a 9-run fifth by Benedict puts them where they are now, headed into the sixth. Benedict batting around in that fifth inning. And they will send Jaden Jones to the plate to start the sixth. Jones has been a real killer for Tuskegee today. Homer twice in this ball game against the Golden Tigers. LeBron Stinson on in relief. His first pitch. That one's in for a strike. Kyrie Broughton started the ball game for Tuskegee. And then Mikhail Mason came on in relief. And now Stinson in relief of Mason. And he falls. The count goes 1-1 on Jones. This one out of the strike zone. 2-1 to Jones. Stinson with the pitch. That one ripped and fouled left side. Jaden Jones jumping all over that fastball, but out too early. 2-2 count. That one fouled off at the plate as well. Stinson with the 2-2 offering. And that one way out of the strike zone. Looked to be a curveball he was trying to throw there. I think it may have gotten out of it, slipped out of his hands. You can see him there kind of licking his palms. May have just slipped out on the delivery. 3-2 count. This one popped up. Catcher Hatch is called off by the first baseman Jones, and Evan Jones makes the catch for Tuskegee. So they finally retire Jaden Jones in this game. Going to pop up to first base. He'd singled and then gone back-to-back home runs for Benedict. Watson steps in, takes a look at strike one from Stinson. This one ripped out to short. Glass trying to come up with it. He fields it, but falls to the surface. Getting to it, can't come up with the throw. Hit so deep in the hole. Glass with the range, but where it was located, no chance to even come up with the throw for Tuskegee. So Watson is aboard. And they go back to the top of the order now with Jamil Mitchell stepping in. Squares to bunt, takes the ball outside. Yeah. That pitch low and inside by Stinson. Two-one count. That one out of the strike zone by Stinson. Count to 3-1 now. Three-one pitch. Swung on and over to the third baseman. Hayes across the diamond for the out at first. And down the second base goes Watson. So Mitchell retired on the 5-3 putout. But Watson able to advance on the fielder's choice. McDuffie stepping in now for Benedict. Takes a pitch outside from LeBron Stinson. Two down. Tuskegee looking for an inning without any runs as this one's popped up in the left field. Willis got a bead on it. And it parachutes down in his glove for out number three. So Tuskegee finally putting up a zero for that Benedict offense. They hold him there 15-5. We go to the bottom of the sixth. Tuskegee trailing. Got him out on offensive comeback here. We'll see if they can after the timeout.
Are you looking for education that leads to career success and something more? We are Tuskegee University, one of the nation's top-ranked HBCUs. We believe in education to fulfill your purpose. Here, you work hard because you dream harder. By pursuing your purpose, you will make a difference. Are you ready for something big? Let's get started.
Hey, future business leader. Launch your success story at one of the nation's premier HBCUs. Learn cutting-edge practices and feed your entrepreneurial spirit. Tuskegee University. We get the business of business education. Tuskegee University's founder, Booker T. Washington, said, "Excellence is to do a common thing in an uncommon way." At many universities, big classes are common. Not at Tuskegee. We have small classes with a 14-to-1 average student-to-teacher ratio. This formula for excellence ensures individualized attention. You get to know your professors, and they get to know you well enough to recommend you for internships, research, graduate programs, and job opportunities. Small classes, big impact. It's all part of educational excellence at Tuskegee University.
Live at Washington Field on the campus of Tuskegee University is Tuskegee Baseball on the Golden Tigers Network. And our coverage of Tuskegee University Baseball on the Golden Tigers Sports Network is brought to you by TNT Fireworks. TNT, America's best-selling brand of and the largest distributor of consumer fireworks. TNT Fireworks, proud supporter of Tuskegee Athletics. And we are just fired up that they are. 15-5. We go to the bottom of the sixth. Tuskegee able to hold Benedict off of the scoreboard in the sixth. New pitcher in the lineup for the Tigers of Benedict. Kenyon Connor Jr. from Columbia, South Carolina. And for a lot of us, that last name sounds familiar. Son of one of the most outstanding coaches in the SIAC, Ken Connor. And certainly had a proud tradition of his work down at Albany State, Coach Connor did. Multiple conference winners generated down in Southwest Georgia. Connor Jr. starts things off with a strike. And his counterpart, LeBron Stinson, down in the count, 0-2. That's a good pitch there. Stinson can only look at it as Connor comes on with his first strikeout since coming in relief. It's very impressive. Got a strong fastball for sure. Connor is one of four in terms of one losses for Benedict. This is his 10th appearance for the Tigers. He started four ball games for them. 23rd inning of work for Connor. Missed on that first fastball. 14 strikeouts on the season for him. Team's batting 267 against the freshman. Curveball stayed on the inside corner. Couldn't catch the plate with it. So the count now 2-0. On Kyrie Broughton. Broughton singled in the first inning for Tuskegee. Flew out to center in the third. Started the game on the mound for the Golden Tigers. Fouls tipped this one off to the right. Connor with the pitch, that one down for ball. And got past the catcher Hall to the backstop. Talking about his father, it's such a major contribution to the SIAC. His mom doesn't do bad as well. Always an annual presence at the SIAC basketball tournament, handling the books for years and years. And it's just a tremendous help as this one's driven to the left field and down. As the center fielder was trying to give chase, Jamil Mitchell not able to get over there soon enough. And that'll fall for a base hit. So Broughton is aboard. They had him played, and right fielder was hugging the line and not quite able to get over there soon enough. So Mitchell was trying to cover a lot of ground to his left and not able to get there. So Broughton gets on board in the sixth with a single out to right field. And that'll bring up the catcher, Mark Hatch. First pitch off the plate to Hatch. Tuskegee trailing by 10. That pitch also off the mark by Connor. Alex Glass waiting on deck for Tuskegee. 2-0 pitch, an inside strike there by Connor. Found the corner. Trying to go back to the outside, missed on the corner. 3-1. Martin get on any way he can here. Walk would be just as fine. That one ripped through the gap left side for a base hit. So Hatch waiting patiently on that 3-1 pitch. Connor had to come in. He did. Hatch was there and delivered a base hit for Tuskegee. I'm so fresh, man. So Hatch will be aboard at first. Broughton pushed down to second base. And here comes the shortstop, Alex Glass. Glass. Ground ball to the third baseman, 5-3 put out in the fifth inning. Got on base on balls in the third. Looking for a base hit here. Connor with the pitch, curveball, tapped on, right to the mound. Connor with an easy play and flip over the first base for out number two. Down So Glass fooled on that pitch a bit. A little tapper just to the left of Connor at the mound. So two down now for Tuskegee in the bottom of the sixth. Harrison Barnes now at the plate. Takes a pitch outside. Runners at third and second. Barnes thought about it, able to hold off on that ball down low. That one off the plate as well. And ball four there. And Tuskegee will take that as well as Barnes takes a walk. So now the bases are loaded for Tuskegee. So Barnes at first, Hatch down at second, and Broughton over to third. And Evans Jones, the first baseman for Tuskegee, steps in. Two down. Two down, base hit here. That pitch is off the plate. That's called a strike there, trying to find that location on the outside corner. That time, Connor's able to hit the target. One and one. Curveball by Connor, finds the mark, takes a count to one and two. Evan Jones standing in, one and two count. Bases loaded. Did not go at it. Low pitch there. Able to hold off on that one. Two two count. Bases full for Tuskegee. That one tapped at the plate and out of play. Jones starting to see a lot of pitches in this sequence now. Maybe he can find some rhythm. Count at two and two. Sack full of Golden Tigers. 2-2 pitch. Tapped on to the third base side. Easy play there for Murray. Able to field it right there and step on third for the out at third base. So Tuskegee threatens here in the bottom of the sixth, but not able to put anybody across. They leave the bases loaded and trail it 15-5 to the Tigers of Benedict College. We'll step out for a timeout. More baseball from Tuskegee on the Golden Tiger Sports Network.
What does education mean when you choose the top HBCU in Alabama?
So one of the things that's been most valuable for my experience at Tuskegee is being able to face challenges head on. I can definitely say here I've learned how to be an advocate for myself, how to speak up, and how to present myself in ways that can help me get opportunities, that help me fix things that may not be right. And I think that's really just the best skill that I've learned here that I can take with me for the rest of my life.
Look home. Where you hang out with friends. Do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
Academy Sports and Outdoors makes it easy to get what you need and have fun out there. Get free shipping at academy.com or get free curbside or in-store pickup at your Academy store.
And we're back live at Washington Field. Play goes continues here as we push our way into inning number 7. LeBron Stinson on the mound for Tuskegee. Benedict trying to win this rubber match between the teams. Right now with a comfortable 15-5 lead over Tuskegee. Still baseball left ahead for both of these programs before the SIAC tournament. A new alignment with the SIAC. Everybody playing just in one rotation. It's not an east-west as it relates to baseball. And it's the top 8 teams that go to Albany for the SIAC tournament. It's coming up in early May. Right now, both of these teams will be outside the window of that. But some baseball still ahead. Tuskegee. Ball games on Tuesday of this week. And then back here on Saturday, all these games here at home with Tuskegee on the AUM on Tuesday. And then next Saturday, a doubleheader with Lane. And then a single game with Lane on Sunday. And the same the following week, this time Lemoyne away from the campus. All those conference contests for Tuskegee. Stinson fires a pitch on the inside. That one's off the plate. For the Tigers of Benedict, they play Spring Hill starting next week or next weekend in a 3-game set. And they finish up their regular season the following week with the Thoroughbreds of Kentucky State. That one on the road. So they have a chance to maybe climb into the top 8 and make the trip to Albany to participate in the tournament. Stinson falling behind early here. 3 balls, no strikes to Murray. And Murray takes ball 4. So he starts the 7th off with a walk. And the shortstop, Todd Bates, comes back up. Bates took a base on ball in the 6th inning. Takes the first pitch from Stinson for a strike. And tight on that pitch, almost hit him. Brushed him off. Count goes to 1-1 on Bates. Throw over the first. Chasing Murray back. Murray stole a base earlier in the ball game and was picked off the 2nd time. To the plate, this one ripped out the left field. That one, foul ball. Had home run distance on it, but he hit it foul. So the long strike against Bakes makes the count 1-2. Justin Murray, third baseman, down at first for Benedict. Shortstop, stop, Todd Bates in the box, takes a ball inside from LeBron Stinson. So Stinson towing the rubber now, getting set for this 1-2 delivery. On its way. And that's lifted into right field. I think it was misplayed, but backing pedaling now is Harrison Barnes to catch up with it and make the catch. Barnes started in on that ball, realized it was carrying a little bit deeper than what he thought, was able to regather and back pedal for the catch. So Bates flies out to Barnes, and that'll bring up Canty. Canty rips one out down in the gap between center and right field. Murray will post up at 2nd base, and Canty with a base hit. So Canty is aboard with a single. Murray down to second. And the pitch hitting now for Mizell. It'll be William Martinez, a sophomore from Miami. So Martinez into the ball game for the first time. Pinch hitting here. Takes the first pitch outside for ball one. Murray down at second. And Bates, or Canty that is, over at first. Stenson with the pitch. That one's on the inside. Nice slide to get that baseball by Mark Hatch from behind the plate. Hatch has really shown some solid defensive skills for Tuskegee in this baseball game. That one ripped on and fouled. Hard line drive near the Tuskegee dugout. Count goes to 2-1. Stenson delivers. This one ripped and through the hole. Right side for base hit. They waved, bobbled on the cutoff there as Evan Jones was trying to make a play at the plate on Justin Murray for Benedict, but not able to corral the baseball on the cutoff. I think Murray would have been in there anyway after a hard hit single. It's past first base. Really no chance for Tuskegee to try to cover that ball. Everybody's kind of covering the base with runners there. And Martinez, fresh off the bench, gets that base hit and drives in a run. So Murray scores there, and that'll send Canty over to third base after the attempt at the plate. Jacob Hall, catcher, back up to the box for Benedict now to pick up another run with runners at the corners. The pitch taken on the inside, throw down to second base, and safe down on the steal was Martinez, and that will send the runner to the plate. And Canty scores. So they threw down with the hopes of getting Martinez, but did not get him on the play down at second base, and Canty able to score. Ball gets away from Hatch, and over the third goes Martinez standing up. So Martinez will take third on that wild pitch. And one down here. In the top of the seventh, Benedict already played at two. Stenson delivers a strike to Hall. Takes the count to 2-2. Swung on. Hall knows he missed a good pitch there. Fouled it off. Two and two. Martinez at third for Benedict. Stenson with the pitch. Off the plate and to the backstop. So now Martinez comes across. So Martinez inserted into the lineup, delivered on a base hit, got an RBI. Now he comes across to score. And the base is cleared again for Benedict. They pushed across three here in the seventh. Pitch to Hall. Trying to go to right field with it. Pushed it too far and out of play. Just trying to follow that pitch that Stinson delivered. Count goes to 3-2. This one on the ground to the shortstop. Glass got a look at it. Lost it on the transition. Everything falling apart now for Tuskegee. Normally sure-handed Alex Glass at shortstop. Fielded it cleanly. When switching it over to the throwing hand. Dropped it. So Hall gets aboard on the E6. And the train just keeps on running for Benedict. Jaden Jones back in there has to step out of the way of a fastball coming at his knees. We said it before, he has just wreaked havoc on Tuskegee today. Finally retired his last time at bat, but started the game with a single. And then in the fourth and the fifth, went deep twice. Good change up there by Stinson, had Jones way out in front of that baseball. Count to 1-1, one down, top of the seventh. This one on the ground to the third baseman. Good play there for one down the second. Glass across the diamond, they got the double play. Nicely done by that Tuskegee infield. Ryan Hayes started it at third base, fielded it clean, got it down there to Glass. And on the pick over the first, they got Jaden Jones for the double play. So Tuskegee wraps up that inning with a double play, but they give up three more runs to the Tigers of Benedict. They lead it now 18-5 as we go to the bottom of the seventh. We'll take a timeout before we do that on the Golden Tigers Sports Network.
Tuskegee University's founder, Booker T. Washington, said, "Excellence is to do a common thing in an uncommon way. At many universities, big classes are common. Not at Tuskegee. We have small classes with a 14-to-1 average student-to-teacher ratio. This formula for excellence ensures individualized attention. You get to know your professors, and they get to know you well enough to recommend you for internships, research, graduate programs, and job opportunities. Small classes, big impact. It's all part of educational excellence at Tuskegee University."
Home, where you hang out with friends, do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
Back live here at Washington Field, Tuskegee trailing at 18-5 to the Tigers of Benedict in this SIAC contest. There's a run rule that's about to come into effect here in this bottom of the seventh for Tuskegee. So Tuskegee's got to notch a few runs here to keep this baseball game going. Within 10. Ryan Hayes, the third baseman, just came up clean to start that double play for Tuskegee in the top of the seventh. He's in the box. Connor fires a pitch at the corner. Trying to go to that same location. Got that one located. One ball, two strikes for O'Connor. A couple of nice deliveries on the two previous pitches. 1-2. Curveball off the plate. Two-two count. Hayes ready. That one just off the plate. We go to full. And a low pitch there by Connor, saying that he did not go. Ask if his Hayes went around on that pitch. He did not. And that will send him down to first base. So Hayes in a must-do situation for Tuskegee gets aboard on a walk. And that'll bring up Cody Willis. Willis looks at the first pitch for a strike. One and one after Connor misses on the fastball. Ryan Hayes down at first. This one low. Willis ahead in the count now 2-1. Murray tight at the corner at third. Missed on the ball. Got right to him. Fires it across the diamond. Went way too late. Just commenting that he was just on the cut of the grass at third base. And the hard shot there by Willis got by him. If he's at regular depth, he's got enough time to slide over and get that baseball. But a break for Willis and Tuskegee. He will be at first, and he'll push Hayes down to second. We'll score that a base hit. And Nicholas Pratt to the plate. Pratt's homer in this baseball game. Nice three-run homer here would be nice. Hayes at second. Willis at first. Pitch is low for ball two. Pratt a victim of a strikeout in the fifth inning. Squares the bunt. Takes a pitch inside instead. I'll run the count now to 3-0. That one off the plate for a walk. So the base is loaded now. Pratt with the walk to first. Hayes to third. And Willis down to second. It's going to be Caden Smith, looks like the sophomore, getting ready to pick up a bat for Tuskegee. And right now we got a pitching change by the Tigers of Benedict. Cypher, this pitching change, take a chance to look at the rule, which means that one team forfeits a game when the opposing team has a 10-run lead after seven innings. This is exactly close to where we are. Tuskegee trailing at 18-5 outside of that 10-run window. But here, with a chance to cut into that, to keep this game going, if they can muster up some runs here in this inning. There we can. Tuskegee University National Athletic Association is a proud sponsor of our broadcast coverage of Golden Tigers Athletics. Golden Tigers Athletics. To find out how you can join this elite group of supporters of Tuskegee University Athletics, visit the Tuskegee University National Athletic Association website at www.tuskegee.edu/TUNAA. And we thank them for their support and coverage of Tuskegee Athletics overall and their particular coverage or support of our broadcast coverage of Tuskegee. At the plate, it's Caden Smith, the sophomore for Tuskegee, picking up the bat and falls behind in the count 0-2. And quickly, Smith is dispatched by Heidman on the mound for Benedict. So the base is still loaded now. And Kyrie Broughton on now to try to see if he can't punch something across. One down after Smith strikes out. And the first pitch off the plate to Broughton. That pitch off the plate as well. Caden Heinemann on the mound for Benedict and finds a strike zone there. Take the count to 2-1, one down. Tuskegee with the bases loaded here. Trying to keep this ball game going. And that pitch just a bit up in the zone as Kyrie took that one for ball three. That one finds a play. Good pitch there from Heidman. Count to 3-2. Tuskegee has left him full a couple of times in this ball game. That one swung and missed by Broughton. Good pitch sequence there from Caden Heidman for the Benedict Tigers. And we're down to the final out here in the bottom of the seventh for Tuskegee if they're not able to push these runs across. Mark Hatch. He's been worked over behind the plate, having to cover three different pitchers today. See if he's deserving of a base hit here. Pitch on the inside for ball one. That one on the inside, and it gets away, and that'll bring one run to the plate for Tuskegee. Ryan Hayes scores on the wild pitch from Heidman. And everybody else moves up one. Louis Willis at third, and Pratt moves on down to second. And Hatch here. Still got runners in scoring position. Takes a pitch at the corner by Heidman. Count to 2-1. Two down, bottom of the seventh. And the pitch. That one's low. So Hatch, want to keep this line moving. Swings at it, ducks it up the middle. It's a slow roller, though. Found some eyes, and it got through for a base hit. So Hatch legging that out for the base hit and drives in a run. Willis scores. Hatch picks up that RBI. Pratt over the third. And Alex Glass, the shortstop, steps in. This is all about keeping the line moving, passing it on to the next guy. Runners at the corners. Two down, bottom of the seventh. Curveball got away. Going to the screen, and that'll plate another runner. And that'll be Pratt scoring. That's how you do it. So Hatch pushes down to second. Glass. Two down. One ball, no strikes. Heidman set for the pitch. Inside. And Glass having to just slide back out of the way of that one. Almost hit him on the inside. And that they go back to the outside corner with a strike there by Heidman. Mark Hatch, the catcher, down at second base for Tuskegee. Right now, it's a 10-run deficit. Got to push him across to keep things going. That one ripped out, past the shortstop, into left field. See if they'll go to the plate on this one. They're going to hold Hatch at third. So the base hit by Glass keeps that line moving. So he singles. 18-8, your score. Tuskegee needs one more run here to keep things going. And Harrison Barnes set to step in to do that. Runners at the corners for Tuskegee. Two down, bottom of the seventh. That pitch off the plate for ball one. Saw that mercy rule up on the screen a while ago. Might not be bad to put it back up there just to remind people where we are. We're at that 10-run run right now, but they got to get it inside of that. There, the pitch. There it is on the screen, which means that one team forfeits a game when the opposing team has a 10-run lead after inning number seven. And boy, we are right on top of it. Thank you, Eric. Here's a pitch. This one swatted to the third base side. It eats up Murray. Murray can't feel the baseball, and Tuskegee pushes a run in. Boy, oh boy. Not out of the building yet. Hatch scores. That'll be an error on Murray at third. Barnes. Get on board with the error, but he'll get on any way he can at this point just to keep things going here. First baseman Evan Jones now at the block. Takes the first pitch, strike on the inside. Tuskegee needed that just to keep this contest alive. Heidman with the pitch. Found the corner again. Jones down in the count 0-2. Here's the pitch. That one off the plate, and the runners advance again. So that'll put Glass over the third. Barnes down to second. You both advance on that wild pitch. One-two count. That one ripped out to center field. Coming in on the run and making the catch is Mitchell. So Benedict finally retires Tuskegee, but Tuskegee does what it has to do to ensure that this ball game continues. They got four in the bottom of the seventh. Score now 18-9, and we're sure to getting this one in for regulation. So Tuskegee keeps things going after they avoid the mercy rule, and we'll take a break and come back and get you started for the eighth. Golden Tiger Sports Network.
Are you looking for education that leads to career success and something more? We are Tuskegee University, one of the nation's top-ranked HBCUs. We believe in education to fulfill your purpose. Here, you work hard because you dream harder. By pursuing your purpose, you will make a difference. Are you ready for something big? Let's get started.
Home, where you hang out with friends, do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
Tuskegee going with the senior Robert Sneed from Powder Springs, Georgia, to take the mound here in the top of the eighth. The lefty, 0-4 on the season. This will be his 15th appearance for the Golden Tigers. 22 2/3 inning pitched for Sneed. He's given up 33 hits, 33 runs, 28 strikeouts on the season. Team's hitting .351 against Sneed. But Tuskegee will change it up with a new look on the mound with the lefty handling things. .189, we go into the eighth. Glad you could join us for our coverage on the Golden Tigers Sports Network. Same teams played on yesterday and split. Going into the eighth inning now. It'll be a Marion Watson. Watson singled his last time up. Squares to bunt. Takes a strike on the inside from Sneed. The lefty fires this one off the mark outside. Count to 1-1. Swung on and missed. Good pitch by Sneed. Past Watson. The 1-2 pitch from the senior. Inside. Count to 2-2. Up top on that pitch goes Sneed. Take the count to 3-2 now. .32 pitch. Called strike three. Good pitch there by Sneed. I think Watson thought he had a pass to first. Instead, he gets the pass to the dugout. So Sneed strikes out Watson at the eighth. And at the plate now is Mitchell. Mitchell's crossed the plate twice in this game for Benedict. Takes another pitch off the plate. Count to 2-0. Now Sneed finds his own. Strike middle of the plate. Count to 2-1. Same spot, 2-2. Sneed's got a nice smooth delivery. That time throws it high. Appears to have to work a little bit up on the top half mechanics, though. Release is kind of high. bit more bend to that body or your release point. That one swung on and driven foul down the left field line. Count full at 3-2, one down, top of the eighth. Off the plate. And Mitchell draws the walk. That brings on Jalen McDuffie in the lineup for Benedict. Looking for his first hit of the ball game. Sneed misses with that first fastball off the plate. Mitchell at first. This one swung on. And a fair ball just over the bag at first base. So McDuffie able to clear that with a baseball that bounced over the head of Jones at first base. And that'll bring up Murray to the plate. So McDuffie got his first base hit of the ball game. Murray swings at it, swats it out of bounds. Sneed ahead in the count 0-2. That pitch tight inside the corner. Actually, after that base hit by McDuffie over first base, Tuskegee having some difficulty getting that baseball back into the field of play. So Mitchell and McDuffie able to advance. Mitchell now at third, McDuffie down at second. Two count to Murray. Low inside, good job on the stop there by Hatch behind the plate. They have just moved him all around the box behind the plate today, trying to stop as many as he could in terms of pass balls or wild pitches. And Murray, he went, and he'll be sent back to the dugout with a strikeout. Tried to hold up on it, but not able to. So Murray strikes out. And it'll be Bates coming into the box. Bates with Mitchell and Duffy. McDuffie on the bags. Mitchell at third. McDuffie at second. Here's the pitch. Swung on, popped up on the infield. And it's floating around there, but Pratt able to finally get up under it with a little bit of wind kicking up here in Tuskegee and filled it for out number three. So Bates pops up to end the inning. And they had two runners on that were left. So it's remains an 18-9 ball game as we go to the bottom of the eighth in Tuskegee coming to the dish to bat. Timeout here on the Golden Tiger Sports Network.
forward to your bright future. Apply to Tuskegee University today.
What does education mean when you choose the top HBCU in Alabama?
So one of the things that's been most valuable for my experience at Tuskegee is being able to face challenges head on. I can definitely say here I've learned how to be an advocate for myself, how to speak up, and how to present myself in ways that can help me get opportunities, that help me fix things that may not be right. And I think that's really just the best skill that I've learned here that I can take with me for the rest of my life.
Look forward to your bright future. Apply to Tuskegee University today.
Academy Sports and Outdoors makes it easy to get what you need and have fun out there. Get free shipping at academy.com or get free curbside or in-store pickup at your Academy store.
Home, where you hang out with friends, do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
Back live at Washington Field, campus of Tuskegee University. Bottom of the eighth, Tuskegee trailing 18-9. Still some life left in them. They avoided the mercy rule in the bottom of the seventh with four across. A couple more opportunities here to claim that lead. Snatch it away from Benedict. This is Ryan Hayes in the box. Hayes, 1-1 on the count here. Swings at it and fouls it off right side. Ryan looking for his first hit of the ball game. Got on a walk. We're able to come around to score earlier in the contest. Right now, count at 2-2. Caden Hinman on the mound for the Tigers of Benedict. Fires the ball low to count to 3-2. Three-two delivery. That's high. So Hayes will take the walk. Cody Willis back to the plate for Tuskegee now. Willis singled back in the seventh. Hinman with the pitch. Curveball on the inside, found the back of the plate. Hayes on at first. 0-1 count to Willis. Tried to go back to that same spot, but missed inside. Count to 1-1. And that one off the plate outside. Try the inside, now they go to the outside, missed on both. Two balls and a strike to the center field of Cody Willis. That one low, but Willis bit on it and swings at it. Take it to 2-2. Cody wishes he'd had that pitch back. 2-2 delivery from Hinman. This one swung on, chopped foul. Well, a little looper off the right field and down for a base hit. Good piece of hitting there by Cody Willis. Stuck the bat out there. And just laid it out in right field for the base hit. So Willis. Pitching change here for Benedict. Hinman coming on, a couple of innings worked for them. Now they'll go back to the bullpen. Tuskegee with two men on. Hayes drew the walk. Willis just delivered on a base hit to right field. Like Bobby Kelly coming on to pitch now for the Tigers of Benedict. And it will be Kelly taking the mound. So Tuskegee now in this bottom of the eighth. A couple of runners on. Going to stay in contention in this ball game. A couple of more conference contests on tap for Tuskegee. It's Lane College. And then Lemoyne Owen to finish the season, have a series, or at least one game, on the 18th, which is Tuesday, against AUM here. Teams getting near the end of the regular season. The Tuskegee will need some help from some other teams if they are going to try to get into that SIAC tournament with only the top eight going. Ball game on Tuesday against Auburn University of Montgomery here at Washington Field. Pitch by Kelly. Sent in the dirt and goes to the backstop. And the runners move up. Nicholas Pratt batting for Tuskegee. Two on. Hayes and Willis. Both moving over on that wild pitch. Kelly delivers a strike here, 1-1. Kelly's pitch swatted on and fouled off to the right. Right here. 1 and 2 to Pratt. Swung on, right past Murray again at third base. Out in the left field. That'll score Hayes, and that'll push Willis over the third with the hard hit single by Pratt left side. He will pick up the RBI as Hayes rounds to score. And Willis over the third. Now Tuskegee. Pinch hitting for Mikhail Mason. Rod is on the corners now for Tuskegee. Trying to find that same spot, missed on the inside. Willis at third, Pratt on first. That pitch off the plate and a four pitch walk. And that'll bring Broughton back to the plate. So Broughton back to the plate now. Bases loaded. Deficit down to 8. Settles in now. No outs here. Bottom of the 8th. Tuskegee has already scored one run in this inning. And base is loaded right now. With the pitch on the inside, called a strike. Adjusting that leg protector, settles back in. Kelly to the stretch, the pitch, that one's low. 2-1. One delivery, swung on, fouled off at the plate. Too big, 2-2 count. Tuskegee runners on every base. Broughton looks at a high curveball. Count goes to 3-2. Nobody out. Walk would be just as good. Get credit for that as well. 3-2 pitch. Swung on. At third base, diving there. That one was caught by the third baseman. Todd Bates moved over the third base, snagged that one out of the air, and tried to come back to the base. Had Willis leaning off on the lean, thought he got back there with the tag, was enough for a double play. That's one down for Benedict. But he was looking for two, thought he had the double play. In the box now for Tuskegee. Catcher Mark Hatch. One down. Hatch had a big base hit this last time up. Swings at one here and misses. Trying to get things going with a rip there. Had a home run cut on it. Kelly with the pitch. Late swing there by Hatch. Fooled on that curveball. Able to send it foul right side. Two pitch coming. Swung on and drilled off the left field for a base hit. Battle plate one. And looking where the cutoff is, he sent that straight into the catcher. So Tuskegee pushes across another run after the base hit by Mark Hatch. So Tuskegee doing a good job of keeping this line moving. Still, the base is full for Tuskegee. Alex Glass in the box for Tuskegee. Takes the first pitch for a strike. Two on the board already for Tuskegee. 18-11. They cut the deficit. Glass reaching down. Fouls that one off right side. Glass down 0-2 on the count. Here's the pitch. Curveball. Bounces toward the shortstop. He'll have to hurry across the diamond with the throw. Safe at first. Glass beat it out. And Tuskegee scores another. It was a high hopper to the shortstop. And Watson had to wait for it to come down before he could field and throw. And that allowed Glass to get down the line. And it allows Tuskegee to bring another run across the plate. So Harrison Barnes up to the plate now. And the base is still full for Tuskegee. And Benedict now having to go to make another pitching change. Yeah. had. A lot of fireworks going on the field here with Tuskegee making a real surge here. Chance for us to thank one of our sponsors, TNT Fireworks. They do the real kind of fireworks, but we got some real fireworks going here. TNT Fireworks, broadcast sponsor of Tuskegee University Athletics coverage of our broadcast coverage of Tuskegee. TNT Fireworks, the nation's largest selling brand of fireworks and also the largest distributor of consumer fireworks in the country. So we thank TNT Fireworks for providing fireworks of that sort. And while we have fireworks going on here with a pitching change for Benedict, kind of a heated discussion between now third baseman Taj Bates after he thought he had that double at third base and the coach for Benedict. And Bates still is upset about that as standing there near the mound with two other Benedict players as they watch the new pitcher coming into the lineup. That's Dwayne Moore, who will be taking over the mound. Didn't know if Bates was going to survive that encounter with the coach after just being vehemently upset about that call at third where he caught a line drive, speared it on the ground, and dove back to the bag and thought he beat the runner, Willis, who was off the bag just a bit for a potential double. But he got no love from the umpire and was getting no love from the coach after they all gathered at the mound. Tuskegee right now enjoying all kinds of love here at Washington Field. Trail it 18-12 now with one down and the base is still loaded. And that'll bring Harrison Barnes back to the plate for Tuskegee. It'll be a left-on-left matchup between Dwayne Moore and Harrison Barnes. First pitch of the sequence. Off the plate. Each team with 16 hits in this ball game. And that one finds the corner. Barnes readies. 1-1 pitch on the way. Ripped and dove in at first base with the out there, but they don't get him at home. Safe at the plate. Hard hit ball to the first baseman. And Jones, diving to the surface, got it and able to tag first for that out. Then tried to come to the plate, but not in time. So Tuskegee pushes another across. So now with runners at second and third, Evan Jones steps in. And Tuskegee, one run closer, 18-13 now with two down. Jones with a couple of ducks out on the pond, can cut it even closer. Takes a look at a fastball across for strike one. Moore delivers. Curveball over for the strike. Froze the bat that time, Harris of Evans Jones. So Evan in the hole 0-2 after two pitches. That one low, good eye, way to lay off of that one, Evan, because that was tempting in the hole like that. 0-2, or 1-2 now, two down. And the pitch. That one, same spot, got away, and here comes Tuskegee to the plate. They will score another one. Streaking home on that play was Harrison Barnes, or not Mark Hatch, coming in to score for Tuskegee. So now the lead down to four. Moving over to third. That's Glass at third now, 18-14. That pitch down low inside again. So Moore started out ahead in the count 0-2. But now Jones has worked him full at 3-2. Swung on. Foul ball just outside of third base. Glass down at third. First baseman Evan Jones in the box, 3-2. Two down, bottom of the eighth. Here's the pitch. Swung on and missed by Jones. So Moore able to win that battle. Tuskegee chipping away at that lead, though. Right, bottom of the eighth. They pick up five. 18-14 the score now. We head into the final frame, the ninth. See if Tuskegee can hold Benedict scoreless in their half of it and what they do in the bottom half. All of that just ahead on the Golden Tiger Sports Network.
Are you looking for education that leads to career success and something more? We are Tuskegee University, one of the nation's top-ranked HBCUs. We believe in education to fulfill your purpose. Here, you work hard because you dream harder. By pursuing your purpose, you will make a difference. Are you ready for something big? Let's get started.
Tuskegee University's founder, Booker T. Washington, said, "Excellence is to do a common thing in an uncommon way." At many universities, big classes are common. Not at Tuskegee. We have small classes with a 14-to-1 average student-to-teacher ratio. This formula for excellence ensures individualized attention. You get to know your professors, and they get to know you well enough to recommend you for internships, research, graduate programs, and job opportunities. Small classes, big impact. It's all part of educational excellence at Tuskegee University.
Home, where you hang out with friends, do homework, relax, explore, where you can be yourself. Come home to Tuskegee University. Get the education that changes lives, including your own.
Back live here at Washington Field, new pitcher on the mound for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. It'll be Jalen Hill, the sophomore from Jonesboro, Georgia. 18-14 lead for the Tigers of Benedict, and Tuskegee trying to hold them right there. And we'll see if Hill is able to do that. Hill on the season. No wins, 0-4 in terms of one loss. This will be his eighth appearance for the Golden Tigers. Started seven games for Tuskegee during the course of the year. 32 2/3 innings pitched for the sophomore. 22 strikeouts on the season for Hill. See what he does in this situation here. It'll be Isaiah Canton in the box for Benedict. And Jalen Hill cocks and fires for his first pitch. Curveball over for a strike. Another curveball, this was swung on. Canty fouls it off right side. So Jalen Hill quickly ahead in the count. Canty doubled back in the seventh for Benedict. Hill rocks and fires. Fastball at the corner, strike three. Froze him right there. Good pitch by Hill. Hill comes out firing. Gets his first K. Martinez in the box again. Took over in that DH role a couple of innings back. Came on the field and delivered with a base hit and eventually scored. This one swung on and missed. One and one. Hill set again. This one popped up. And looks like that one's going to go out of play, and it will. So Hill quickly ahead in this count, one and two. See if he throws a curveball here. Oh, they go fastball, just missed on the corner. Set it at two and two now, one down. Hill readies, fires. Up, ground ball, third base, across the diamond. Perfect throw there by Hayes, and they retire Martinez. Substitution into that lineup for the Tigers of Benedict. Caden Hinman. And that's a strike delivered there by Jalen Hill. Fastball inside and low, count to one and one. Sophomore readies, fires, pop up. They hustle at it. Who's going to get it? And that third base is squeezed there by Hayes. How about that? Jalen Hill pumped up as he goes to the Tuskegee dugout. Three up and three down for the sophomore from Jonesboro. Fine job of pitching by him, struck the first one out, got a ground ball, and a little short pop up to the third base. So we go to the bottom of the ninth. Tuskegee trailing at 18-14. They need four, and they'll take five to win it. Let's step out and see if they can do that when we come back.
The Home Depot's Retool Your School program is back, and this year, 30 campus improvement grants are up for grabs. Want to know how your school could win its share of $1 million? Get involved. That's right. After your HBCU signs up, make some noise. Vote on Twitter, on Instagram, and on RetoolYourSchool.com. Go in. Go off. Go hard. Vote nonstop. Your school could be a grant winner, and that's how you retool your school.
Back live, things are getting tighter here at Washington Field, bottom of the ninth. Tuskegee needs a four spot to tie things up. Trailing at 18-14, Benedict. New second baseman in there is Minkster. He'll take over in the lineup there. Watson moved over the shortstop. And then Murray was taken out as Bates took over at third. So Minkster at second now. And Murray moved over the first, actually. So it's Murray at first, Minkster at second, Watson at short, and Bates at third, the new set for Benedict. At the plate for the Golden Tigers, Ryan Hayes, the third baseman. And here's the pitch. First in there for a strike. Dwayne Moore delivers the first pitch for a strike. Hayes readies. Takes a look at a ball high. Willis waits in the deck on deck for Tuskegee. 1-1 pitch. Swung on and missed. by Hayes. Hayes had a good look at it. Diving fastball there from Dwayne Moore. Hayes not able to catch up with it. One ball, two strikes. And the 1-2. Pitch low. Take it to 2-2. Bottom of the ninth. Tuskegee needs some base runners here. At 2-2. That one ripped and right over to Bates at third. Fires across the diamond for out number one. So one down here in the bottom of the ninth. Hard hit ball, but hit it right to Bates. Cody Willis, center fielder, coming to the plate for Tuskegee. One down, bottom of the ninth. Moore fires. First pitch for a strike. Tuskegee needs some runners. Got to get on base. That's how you started. 0-1 pitch, swung on, popped up and out of play right side. Willis down in the count, 0-2. Here's the pitch, stays alive with a foul off right side. Two count on the way. Moore with the pitch. Curveball. And staying alive by just punching it out. Down by first base. Off the field of play, so Willis able to stay alive in this bat. Just can't take anything close at this point. Got to get a bat on it. That one's not close, out of the zone up high. One ball, two strikes. One, two delivery. Popped up. Coming back here. I don't think they got an eye on it yet. Catcher circling and makes the catch. Boy, that was a circus catch there. Started out late, couldn't find it. Had to range hard to his right to make that catch. So they retire Willis. The battle for him from the box, but out number two. So Nicholas Pratt, the final hope for the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee. They have battled and battled back in this ball game several times. But down to that final out now. First pitch by Moore is in tight for ball one. After Benedict got nine in the fifth, it looked like things were certainly done with the mercy rule facing Tuskegee. But they rallied and they got four in the sixth, and then they came up with five in the seventh to keep things moving. Squaring the bunt, forcing that high pitch from Moore. But now we're at the bottom of the ninth, two down, nobody on. Moore with the pitch, finds the zone with that one. Three balls, one strike. Pratt trying to work him to get that walk if he can. 3-1 offering. Down and called a strike on the inside. Pratt thought he had cleared it for the walk. Now we come down to the final pitch. Two out, 3-2 count. Bottom of the ninth. Moore fires. swung on and fouled off. So Pratt stays alive. Three, two on its way. And inside for ball four. So Pratt worked him for the walk. So coming to the plate now for Tuskegee, Jalen Hill. Hill held them scoreless and hits the top half of the ninth. Now Tuskegee needs him to create some scores. More sets. Hill squares. Takes a pitch on the inside for a ball. Fires. That one finds the range. Count to one and one. Pratt down at first on the walk. Hill swings at a pitch over the top of it. Takes it to one and two. So Tuskegee now down to its final strike. 1-2 on its way. Inside. Good take there by Jalen Hill. Take it to 2-2. That one low and inside. Gets away from the catcher. Down the second goes Pratt. And the count goes full to Jalen Hill. Keep the line moving. Tyree Broughton standing on deck, hoping for an opportunity with a 3-2 coming here to Jalen Hill. Moore rocks, fires, fastball got him on the strikeout. Hill not able to get the bat up and going, and Benedict on the strikeout of Jalen Hill. They claim it 18-14 over the Golden Tigers of Tuskegee in this rubber match. They split on yesterday, and Benedict claims the win here this Sunday afternoon to win the series. 18-14 the final score. Tuskegee drops it to the Tigers of Benedict College. And that will do it for our coverage here from Washington Field. Special thanks to Tuskegee University President Dr. Charlotte Morris, Director of Athletics Reginald Ruffin, Deborah Rogers, Deputy Director, Athletics Director, Tanya Lee and Stefan Smith from the Communications and Marketing Department, Nick Brown as always with Game Operations and Jordan Benson, and to our production team led by Eric Tabor, that is, always doing an outstanding job in terms of our coverage of Tuskegee Athletics. Joined this weekend by Eric Tabor Jr. He's the real brains of that outfit. He's our assistant producer and did an outstanding job joining us here this afternoon. And to our camera crew, Matthew Jackson Starks, and to Cameron McIntosh, wonderful shots guys from the coverage here at Washington Field. That'll do it once again. Tuskegee drops it to the Tigers of Benedict College. And from Washington Field, Charles Ward saying thanks so much for joining us for this weekend of Tuskegee softball and baseball. And we'll see you next time here on the Golden Tigers Sports Network.